ocean, higher than any bird ever blew, longer than there've been stars up in the heavens. I've been in love with you, stronger than any mountain cathedral, truer than any tree ever grew, deeper than any forest primeval. I am in love with you. I'll bring fire in the winters, you'll send showers in the springs, we'll fly through the falls and summers with love. Burning lines in the book of our lives, though the binding cracks and the pages start to yellow, I'll be in love with you. I'll be in love with you. There've been stars up in the heavens. I've been in love with you. I am in love with you.
Let me give my heart and on, every Jewish husband can double check to be sure he has the right bride. But they all wore these chadors, you know, you see them yet in modern day Iran. So I'm not sure that he really knew Rachel or Rachel's face. But of course, ultimately when he married first Leah, then he made sure that the next bride, he worked 7 years for the first, worked 7 years for the second bride. You'll do better than that. You'll do better than that, Mark. So this is the first tradition. The other tradition, which is probably more significant, is that when Isaac saw his bride, she put the veil over her face.
Achoteni at hayi le'alfei revava yisimech Elohim kesara Rivka Rachel v'lea yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha Adonai Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'chuneka Isa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom.
Now the English.
May you be fruitful and prosper. And
to that we say Amen.
May God make you as Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah. May the Lord bless you and guard you. May the Lord show you favor and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you kindness and grant you peace. And let us say,
Amen. And that was said with a great deal of tenderness and meaning. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to proceed with the signing of the ketubah, and Rabbi Schrantz will honor us as one of the Adim, one of the witnesses. Well, that's good, thank you. And
just look up at the camera after you're done signing.
Very good. This is so much silence here. It's like Bush and Gorbachev signing.
Excuse me, we're running out of picture. As if you're signing.
With the other hand, I want you to really pull hard. And this is called Mashika. This is the acceptance of the ketubah and its contents and its meaning. Now I want to ask you, do you agree to all of the conditions? Oh, let's not have grandmother. All the conditions that are inherent in the ketubah.
Yes, I do.
Oh, good. I was worried. Now you can let go of this. All right. The ketubah is yours, but we'll give it to you under the chuppah. All right? And now, ladies and gentlemen, the last thing we need to do, because we're going to be doing two wedding ceremonies tonight, not one. Not to worry, the price of one. Only for the price of one, right, Murray? Two weddings. And the second, of course, in parallel, is the civil marriage, and we're going to ask the two witnesses who are, you address here and you city and state here, okay?
Okay.
In that order. But remember, you're not married until after I sign it, so no fooling around.
Okay.
Just wanted to be sure of this. Very good. Thank you very much.
Hold the pen and pose this way. Smile.
We're going to put on the front page of the LA Times tomorrow morning.
There you go. I can be a little happier.
What do you think? Are we ready for a wedding? Very good. Thank you very much.
Just like pause, right?
That's it.
Thank you.
recipients of God's blessings at this very, very precious moment in your lives. The Chazan chanted, Barachnuchem Beit Adonai. We say we bless you from this house of God. For you, this place has very special, extraordinary meaning. We pray that this house of God be a source of contentment and nurturing for you and indeed for your loved ones. And so, with all of them gathered about you, I join in prayer that God's glory may be an everlasting blessing to both of you as you now enter the bliss of married life. The happiness in your hearts is expressed, a tear here and there, the bride, but the joy is self-evident. And it is in that happiness and joy that we thank God for his blessing of love, which we celebrate tonight, formally consecrating your love for each other. I pray that you'll always rejoice in that love, graced by delight through your mutual affection. This is an unforgettable moment in your lives. It's full of beauty, it's full of mystery. To consecrate this moment, I shall pronounce the blessing over the first cup of wine, which in a moment you will drink as a symbol of the joy and the love that we know you will share from this day on as husband and wife. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kidushanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al ha'arayot. V'asar lanu et harusot, v'hitir lanu et hanesuot lanu al yedei chupa v'kidushin. Baruch atah Adonai, v'kadesh amo Yisrael al yedei chupa v'kidushin. Mark, would you please drink of this cup of wine? And as you lift Sharon's veil, share its contents with her. Thank you. Do we have the rings, please? Mark, in the tradition of the Jewish people, I now ask you to offer this beautiful ring to your bride, Sharon, and upon her acceptance, to place it upon her right-hand forefinger, symbolic of your mutual desire to enter into the days of your life with one another. And as you do so, would you please repeat after me the ancient formula of the traditional Jewish wedding vows. Hare.
Hare.
At.
At
Mekudeshet,
Mekudeshet,
the word
Li,
Betabat,
Betabat,
Zo, Kedat,
Kedat,
Moshe,
Moshe,
Ve-Yisrael.
Ve-Yisrael.
Mark, just to be sure that you absolutely understand what these words mean and what you said, this is the means by which you have asked the Sharon to be consecrated unto you as your wife in accordance with the law of Moses and Israel. And Sharon, all of us under the chuppah certainly witness to the fact that you accepted the ring, and I know with a great deal of joy. And this ring is your gift to Mark, and as you place it upon his finger, would you please repeat after me the four lovely words from the Shir HaShirim, Ani,
Ani,
Ledodi,
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 Li. And I know that these words certainly express the sense of your heart. I am my beloved's, and my beloved is mine. Just a few moments ago, we gathered family, friends, witnesses to sign this beautiful ketubah. It is really a magnificent piece of art, a gift from your grandparents, Mark. It's colorful, it's joyous, and it really reflects so much of what you're all about. Matzati et Ahavat Nafshi, I have found the love of my soul. the text says, and then a depiction of Yerushalayim, of Jerusalem, and in the corner, you have to look for it, two people very happily doing some wonderful Israeli folk dances. B'sheni b'shabbat arba'a yamim l'chodesh tevet shnat hameshet arafim b'shva me'ot hamishim b'shalosh b'riyat olam leminyan shalmonim kan מטה לוס אנג'לס במדינת אמריקה הצפונית. איך החתן משה בן יהודה לייב ושושנה למשפחת ברמן, המלה להדה בתותה שרה בת שבע בת פסח לייב ובריינה למשפחת רוזנבאום. אבילי לאונטו כדת משה וישראל והכל שריר וקיים. This is to certify that on the second day of the week, the fourth day of the Hebrew month of Tevet in the year 5753, corresponding to the 27th day of December 1992, the holy covenant of marriage was entered into between the bridegroom, Mark Berman, and his bride, Sharon Beth Rosenbaum. The bridegroom made the following declaration to his bride: "Be my wife according to the law of Moses and Israel. I faithfully promise that I will be a true husband unto you. I will honor and I will cherish you. I will work for you. I will protect and support you, and will provide all that is necessary for your sustenance, even as it beseems a Jewish husband to do." Sharon, I think these are very wonderful promises. "I also take upon myself all such further obligations for your maintenance as are prescribed by religious statute. And the said bride has plighted her troth unto him in affection and in sincerity, and has thus taken upon herself the fulfillment of all the duties incumbent upon a Jewish wife. This covenant of marriage was duly signed, and now it is your property, Sharon. We're going to convey it to you. Mark, would you please take it in hand and convey it to Sharon. This is symbolic of the fact that it will be yours to keep and to hold the rest of your life together." The Sheva Brachot, the seven benedictions of the traditional Jewish marriage ceremony. But before the Chazan begins, I want to ask the Talit to be brought forward and to be placed about your shoulders. And this is a tradition taken from the Sephardic heritage. It is meant to convey that the mitzvot, the commandments of the Jewish faith, bind you and hold you together in joy, and that through your lives, the fulfillment of these mitzvot will have great meaning in your home and in the family that you will establish.
Oh,
Sharon, Mark, I want to tell you I'm very, very pleased to officiate at your marriage ceremony tonight. No human deed ever occurs in a vacuum. And certainly the marriage vows pronounced by you, a very significant milestone in the lives of so many, many people. As you've already discovered, your decision to become husband and wife has profound impact, I would say, on everyone gathered here and so many others. And yet, while your decision affects so many others, it is the most personal, the most intimate act each of you has ever undertaken. It bespeaks many, many joys and also many responsibilities. It reflects the hopes and aspirations of your families, and yet places on both of you, and you alone, the responsibility to build a home in which love and devotion to each other will be the catalyst for the joys of a very, very happy marriage. I'm especially thrilled to officiate at your wedding ceremony because I have known the two of you for so many years. Tova and I have had the privilege of knowing your parents for a long time. Both of your families have been an integral component of the larger Sinai Temple family. Both of you are intimately involved in Jewish life, the Jewish community, Sinai Temple. This sanctuary is no stranger to either of you, and certainly not to your loved ones. Sharon, I often see your dear parents, Sabrina and Philip, on Shabbat morning, together with Rosa, your dear mother, Mark. And it's so wonderful to see them now standing next to you, savoring the joy of seeing their children become husband and wife. Heightening the pleasure of this moment is the presence of your dear grandparents. Sharon, your dear grandmother, Molly, has come here from Florida, and your grandparents, Harry and Fanny, have made the journey from Jersey City to celebrate with you. And they are joined, Mark, by your very happy grandparents, Renee and Henry, whose illness is a source of concern to all of us. They're here thanking God for the privilege of, how do we say it, shepping nachas and being witness to this thrilling occasion. As I said before, your beautiful ketubah is their gift of love to both of you. Not to be outdone are your siblings, Debbie and Reuben and Alan, all realize that you are the first of each of the families to stand under the chuppah. And you certainly are a wonderful model to them. As a matter of fact, this event might never have happened had it not been for the coincidence that Alan and you, Sharon, were in the same high school class and then continued your friendship at UCLA. It was about 5 years ago that Alan introduced you, Mark, to Sharon. That's the genesis of your wonderful friendship. You saw each other in concert with many, many friends, and then when you enjoyed that Israeli folk dancing, pleasant conversations, events that culminated in the romance that brings all of us very happily together under this chuppah to celebrate your marriage. And that romance is based on some very significant fundamentals. Everyone who knows you testifies to your sweet and gentle dispositions, the sincerity that guides your every step, and the mutual commitment you have made to the highest standards of family values and our sacred Jewish tradition. Shan, you have just about completed your work for a master's degree in Jewish education, and your teaching skills have already motivated hundreds of students in our own school to attempt to achieve even more understanding of their Jewish heritage. It is you who has designed an extraordinarily effective and sensitive curriculum for our religious school on how best to teach the concept of tzedakah to our children. And you have done so out of the fullness of your heart, the deepest conviction of your faith, and the great skill that you bring to the teaching profession. Mark, you will be receiving your doctorate at UCLA in electrical engineering. It's great testimony to your intellectual capacity and your perseverance. I must say how proud your dear father Victor, whose spirit certainly is felt under this chuppah, how proud he would have been of your achievement. Your studies at the Hebrew University, your stay at a kibbutz in Israel, and your personal adherence to the rites and rituals of our tradition have already become part and parcel of the way the two of you celebrate every Shabbat, each festival of the Jewish calendar, and you do so in a full splendor. A testimony to the strong bond that holds you to your family is the beautiful ring that you, Sharon, received from Mark. The same one that your father received from your mother when they stood under the chuppah. You see, it is a symbol of the continuity of family, the continuity of faith, which so characterizes this beautiful, beautiful event. Your marriage has all the ingredients anyone can hope for. A beautiful bride who has, as we say in Yiddish, alle meilus, a handsome groom, an overpowering commitment to the noblest traditions of family values, and an unfailing bond to the best traditions of Yiddishkeit. It's a combination of virtues that is bound through the adherence of the mitzvot which are represented by the talit in which you were enveloped and which bound you together, as the Chazan chanted the Shavah Brachot. You see, that's the symbol of the mitzvot, of the presence of the Shekhinah in your lives, and your commitments to imbue the family with which we pray God will bless you with the deepest meaning of love and of faith. You've discovered the sacredness of sharing your optimistic belief in humankind. You have invoked into your life elements of art, faith, beauty, love, sensitivity, intellect. And I recite these in the prayer that all of these beautiful qualities in both of you will combine to enhance the joy, the happiness, and marriage that you anticipate. The whole world is before both of you. I know that all of your family and all of your friends will join silently with the Chazan and with me as we invoke the ancient benediction of our people upon you. God bless and guard your love and affection for each other. May God show you favor in your marriage. May He be gracious unto you. Love and harmony, and of shalom, of peace. Peace in your life together as husband and wife. Now, Mark and Sharon, since both of you have joined voluntarily in this ceremony which binds you together in marriage, according to the laws of the state of California and the traditions of the Jewish people, it is my joy, my honor, my pleasure, my delight to pronounce you to be husband and wife. And Mark, in the tradition of our people, I ask you to step on the glass and say, Mazel Tov.
Oh, say shalom bimramah, Yasser Shalom Aleinu. We are called Israel. We Baruch, we Baruch. Aveno say Shalom Bim Ramah. Yasser Shalom Aleinu. We are called Israel. We Baruch, we Baruch. Amen. Yasser Shalom. Yasser Shalom. Shalom aleinu, real kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom. Shalom aleinu, real kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu, real kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom. Shalom aleinu, real kol Yisrael. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom. Shalom aleinu, real kol Yisrael.
To invite the entire bridal party to step out on the dance floor. Ladies and gentlemen, let's invite everyone on the dance floor to join the bride and groom. And all I ever needed was the one, like freedom feels when wild horses run, when stars collide, like you and I, no shadows block the sun. You're all one. There are caravans we follow, drunken nights in dark hotels, when chances breathe beneath the silence, where sex and love no longer gel. For each man in his time is king, until he walks along the beach and sees his future in the water. A long heart within his reach, and all I ever needed was the one, like freedom flies when wild horses run, when to lie like you and I. No shadows mark the sun. You're all I ever needed, baby, you're the one. It's a samba. Pretty woman, won't you pardon me, pretty woman? I couldn't help but see, pretty woman, that you look lovely as can be. Are you lonely just like me?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. need your love. Godspeed your love. To me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Lonely rivers sigh, wait for me, wait for me. I'll be coming home, wait for me. Oh, oh, my love, my darling, I've hungered for your touch a long, lonely time. I need your love. I need your love. Godspeed your love to me.
Hi, Mark and Sharon. First of all, I want to say Mazel Tov, and thank you for having me here. It really meant a lot to me to have me playing a part in the wedding, and I also really enjoyed coming a little early and helping put the thing together. It's really been a lot of fun. Now, I guess this all started 4.5 years ago with Mark back in Israel, and ever since, it's just snowballed. I've been coming backwards and forwards a little more than you guys, but it's all been worth it. And Sharon, I met you first, I think it was, at Israeli Dancing, and things continued from there. We spoke a lot on the phone. I know our parents haven't appreciated long-distance phone bills, but that's the way it goes. So, once again, thanks for having me here. I've really enjoyed it, and may you both have many, 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 many credit cards together.
Sharon and Mark, I wish you nothing but the best of happiness. Mazel tov, lots of love. Sharon, I remember the days when we were so little playing in Edison, New Jersey, going to your grandma and grandpa's house, and today we're here celebrating your wedding in a few months. God willing, you'll be with me in New Jersey. We'll be celebrating mine, and from there, who knows? Anyway, again, mazel tov, lots of luck and lots of love.
It doesn't mean, obviously, Sharon and I have been friends for many, many years, for but
talk to Sharon. Don't talk to me.
Okay. Okay, I'm talking to you, Sharon. I'm talking this. Okay. Sharon, you look so different. Anyway, we've been friends for more than about 11 years now, and we've both grown and matured, I hope. No more following young men around. You found your man. Congratulations. Mark is a wonderful man, and I wish you both the best in the whole world. And this day has meant, for me, one of my best friend joining, and her now husband, and gosh, I'm a loss for words, and I'm a journalist. you starting your life with someone, and I know you will be very happy, the two of you, and whatever you plan on doing for your career. I know family, you'll have a wonderful family. Mark's family is wonderful, and your family is the same, and the two just match. And I wish you both the best, and I love you both.
Hi, Mark and Sharon. I just want to say, well, first to you, Mark, I'm glad that we've been friends for 11 years. We've been through a lot, and, you know, I can still remember that first day when we met in physics class. And Sharon, it's been great meeting you, too. In the last 2 years, I've watched you guys grow, and I think this day has been very special day for you guys. For me, it only marks a beginning, because now this begins the next phase of our lives, where we're now adults, and I'm looking forward to sharing myself with your family and becoming a part of your family and interacting with your children. And I wish you the best of luck for years to come, and I hope that your marriage stays strong as it is today.
Sharon Mark, this is coming from your favorite pagan Christian. I'm just kidding, you know. I'm so happy that I could be here tonight to share in your happiness, really. And I would like to say, Sharon, that you've been a great friend, and you introduced me to life in Los Angeles, and you kept me real, and I really appreciate it. And you know that I really love you, and you're a great friend, and I'm really happy that you had me here tonight. And Mark, I'm really happy that you and Sharon are together. And I don't know what else to say. I don't have a big speech ready here, but really, I'm happy for you both, and congratulations. Bye.
Okay, Sharon, you had no right to be that beautiful. You stole the show. But then maybe you did steal the show. It was your show and Mark's. I love you both, and I hope you'll be very happy.
Thank you for the wedding. It was beautiful, Mr. and Mrs. Rosenbaum, to inviting us. I hope the bride and groom be happy and healthy, and we enjoy it very much. And a lot of nachas for them.
To the club. Got as far as the door. It's not the same without you. Oh, I don't know much anymore. Well, darling, I guess my mind's still at ease. Nevertheless, why fool around with memories? Been invited on dates. Could've gone, but what for? It's not the same without you. Don't get around much anymore. Well, now this was a big hit in the 40s. We're going to take you up through the 50s and 60s and see a little swing in each era. You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Your kind of love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, grave all the facts. You came along, you thought it was. Came along and moved me, honey. I changed my mind, cause you're so fine. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Excuse me, baby. It feels so good. Hold me, baby. I want to love you like a lover should. You're fine, you're so kind. I tell the world that you're my, 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 my. You twiddle my thumb. I'm real nervous, but it sure is fun. Oh, baby, you drive me crazy. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Ha ha ha! it feels so good. Hold me, baby. I only love you like a lover should. You're fine, you're so kind. I tell the world that you're mine. You wreck my nerves up, you tread on my phone. I'm real nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby, you drive me crazy. Oh, yeah.
Sharon, you got married, and Mark did too. and Mazel Tov. And if I knew more Hebrew, I would say something, but you know how much Hebrew I know. But I'm sure there'd be a digation in somewhere. So Mazel Tov, and I'm very happy and very excited. And you look beautiful, and your hair is great, and your face is great, and your dress is great, and everything is great, and Mazel Tov. And, well, see you next semester. Sucks to be us. No, but we're graduating, so I'll see you then. Bye.
To Sharon and Mark, this is a super occasion for a family to get together. It's just been wonderful. You don't know how happy you've made me. You both invited me into your home when I moved to the left coast. And I want to congratulate both of you on this most happy occasion. I love you, and Dick sends his love too. Be well, be happy, and enjoy your life together. All my love, Cousin Joe and Cousin Richard.
And I want to say congratulations so much, and as I already mentioned to you, that I really want to congratulate you and welcome Mark into the family, because he is just the greatest person I could ever imagine for my sister, Sharon. And you make an incredibly good couple, and I don't know that there's anybody better for both of you at this point in time. You're just incredibly perfect together. And I want to say you are some people that make me very happy to be with, and Andy is making me laugh now. But nonetheless, I'm really happy that both of you found each other, and I wish you continued happiness, and I hope that it's continued happiness with all of us involved.
I hear you, my dear, in twilight time. Even in shadows gather splendor. As day is done, light and a spark will soon surrender the setting sun. I count the moments, darling, till you're here with me together. At last, at twilight time. Oh, 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 yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm the great pretender.
Ooh.
Pretender that I'm doing well. My need is such. I pretend too much. I'm lonely, but no one can tell. Oh, 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 yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm the great pretender. Oh, laughing and gay like a clown. I seem to be, but I'm not. You see, I'm wearing my heart like a crown. Pretending you're still around. Took a walk and passed your house late last night. All the shades were pulled and drawn way down tight. From within a dim light cast two silhouettes on the shade. Oh, what a lovely couple they made. Put his arms around your waist, held you tight. Kisses I could almost taste in the night. Wondered why I'm not the guy whose silhouettes all the shade. I couldn't hide the tears in my eyes. Silhouettes,
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 silhouettes, silhouettes,
silhouettes,
silhouettes.
I stepped out the tub, my feet on the floor. I wrapped a towel around me, then I opened the door.
Splish, splash, I forgot about the bath.
I went and put my dancing shoes on.
Big bang, I saw the whole gang sitting on the living room rug. Flip-flop, they were doing the bar, and all the queens and the dancing bar. Lollipop, Peggy Sue, golly, Miss Molly was even there too. Splish, splash, I forgot about the bath. Oh, when I put my dancing shoes on. Oh, yeah. Back in 1961, Everybody was doing this dance. Let's see if you can do it too. Come on, baby. Let's do the twist. Hey, come on, baby. Yeah. Let's do the twist. Take me by my little hand and go like this. I said around and around. Up and down, around and around, up and down, around and around, and up and down, and one, two, three, kick, one. Well, you guys are great. How about this one, 1962? Everybody did the swim. Let me see you do the swim. Whoa. How about the backstroke? How about the breaststroke? All right now, how many of you remember how to hold your nose and go underwater? All right now, 1963, they did a dance called the locomotion.
Everybody's doing a brand new dance, yeah.
Come on, baby, do the locomotion.
Chugga chugga motion, that railroad train, yeah.
Come on, baby, do the locomotion.
Never been a dance that's so easy to do. It even makes you happy when you're feeling blue. So
come on, do the locomotion with me.
You gotta swing your hips out. Come on, baby, jump up, jump back. Well, I think you got the knack. What a thing that you can do to make me change, yeah.
Come on, baby, do the locomotion.
Chugga, chugga, motion, that railroad train, yeah.
Come on, baby, do the locomotion.
Never been a dance that's so easy to do. It even makes you happy when you're feeling blue. So come on, do the locomotion.
Oh, you guys are doing great. All right, now 1964, the dance was The Jerk, and the song was by the King's Men, and it went like this.
Across the sea, the love that she waits for me. You know that love here to wait some time. Pick her up and her check is mine. You'll do what you like.
Whoa, no.
We gotta go.
Yeah.
Do what you like. Oh, she won.
Hamburger stand. Forgot all about the library. She told her old man.
Hamburger stand.
With the radio blast and go cruising as fast as she can.
Hamburger stand.
And we'll have fun. Daddy takes the demon away. You knew all along your dad was getting wise to you now. Since he took you set of keys. You're thinking that you're finding out through the night. Come along with me. We got a lot of things to do now. We'll have fun. Daddy, take the TV away. Young man, and I'm sure you will find many ways to have a good time.
Hey.
It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
YMCA.
I don't hear ya.
Sharon, Mark, we're so glad we came. Our next time we see you will be at Jeffrey's wedding on March 21st. We love you both. Everything is just beautiful. Our love to both of you for always. Aunt Thelma and Uncle Mike. You want to say something?
No. I'm not saying a word. The mouthpiece said everything for us.
Hi, Mark and Sharon. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Hi, this is Greg Martin.
And this is Michelle Oliver.
And we're coming to you live from the beautiful Sinai Temple on beautiful Wilshire Boulevard.
We're here to wish you a very, very wonderful day. And to say that we really
already
loved
was.
Your wedding. We had a great time.
And if you're watching this on your 65th wedding anniversary, L'chaim. And hope there are many more left.
Good luck, and we'll see you later. Bye!
Just wanted to tell you both that I love you, and I think you're great, and you're great together, and I'm really glad I could make it. Take care of yourselves.
Sharon and Mark, we wish you the best.
But then you knew that, and I think everyone else has wished you that also. But it's very important that we said it also.
So we have said it.
But we want to say some more. And also, I think it's very important that we say,
congratulations in every bit of your life.
And
we hope you the best.
And give us a call when you're back so we can beat you at some other games.
Yes.
Sharon, I wouldn't have missed this for the world. This is your first cousin Andrew, by the way, if you don't recognize me. Anyway, congratulations, good luck, and have a happy life. In your new life. Hey, you're gonna cut us off here, pal. Anyway, congratulations. And maybe I'll see you in another eight years. No, I saw you 2 years ago. I'll come back whenever I can. You should visit me, though, in Boston. This is your first cousin Andrew speaking for Larry and Josh.
Hi, Sharon and Mark. I'm so proud to see my beautiful artwork made it here to your wonderful wedding ceremony and this lovely backdrop with this beautiful piece of something dedicated to somebody for anything. Anyway, Mazel Tov, we're having a wonderful time. It's great to be here despite the difficulties that we've had, but it's all worth it and it's been wonderful and you should have a lifetime of happiness and enjoy this. And you know, Gary was going to throw this out, and I'm really upset, so you better put this somewhere and save this forever, because this is very important, and Donnie and I wish you lots of love, fun, and have a great honeymoon, and enjoy your lingerie, and enjoy the sun and fun, and we'll see you when you get back.
Mark and Sharon, congratulations. This is a great wedding, and we expect that the next date on Mark's board is going to be the birth of your child.
Anyway, Mark and Sharon, congratulations again, and, I think I've been looking forward to this day just as much as you have, because there's been a constant reminder on that board all that time. I wonder what's going to take
year.
Its place now. But anyway, congratulations, we're having a great time, and we wish you a great life together, and I'm sure you're going to be happy together.
Hello, everybody. I'd like to welcome everybody, especially our out-of-town guests. It was very nice of you to all come. And everybody, thank you for being here. I'd like to say a few words for Mark and Sharon, my brother and new sister-in-law. Do you want to come up here? Mark and Sharon, as you know, family is the building block of the Jewish community and provides a strength for the individual. In observing families in all stages of life, from yours to the beginning of togetherness, to couples with newborns, on to later stages of life, I have seen the essence of support that couples provide each other. From the exuberance of newfound love to the trials and tribulations of daily life, there are peaks and valleys that everyone must endure. You two share a fondness of each other and the excitement for life that will make the highs higher and slide you through the lows. I see the love that you both receive from your families set a firm foundation for your future. You know the value of unity, caring, affection, and truth, and this will carry you forward. These values have been sent down from generation to generation. Sharon, you learned from your mother, Bryna, a strong woman who made a Jewish home, educated you, and helped steer your family. And your father, Phil, who tirelessly provided and taught you by example in his own way. Mark, you have seen our mother, Rosa, raise us while going to law school and working, all the while keeping a Jewish home. And our father, Victor, que en paz descanse, who, with dedication and fervor, strove to teach us ambition and to keep a Jewish identity in Ahavat Yisrael, and who would stop at nothing to provide us with all our needs. We all know how much it would have meant to him to see you get married and to share in this simcha. Now, your parents are entrusting you in each other's hands. The torch has been passed, and you will now draw upon what you have learned to construct a union, a family, and a life. It is your turn to start setting an example, which looks very promising, I might add. Sharon, in studying at the University of Judaism for a master's degree in education, you're preparing to teach the next generation. And Mark, in pursuing your PhD in electrical engineering, you're looking forward to a successful career in microchip design. Together, I'm sure you will build on your foundation a unit that will fortify you and your family you make. In short, everything I see indicates that this is the beginning of a wonderful, fruitful life together. From strength to strength, from simchas to simchas, let us all raise our glasses to Mark and Sharon Berman for love, health, happiness until 120. L'chaim.
The world was in bloom. There were stars in the sky, except for the few that were there in your eyes. Dear, as I held you so close, two hearts gently beating were murmuring low, my darling, I love you so. The night seemed to fade into blossoming dawn. The sun shone anew, but the dance lingered on. Could we but relive that sweet moment sublime, we'd find that our love is unaltered by time. Seemed to fade into blossoming dawn. The sun shone anew, but the dance lingered on. Could we
But really, that sweet moment sublime, we find that our love is unaltered by
Chicago way. He had a boogie sound that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. And when he never gave up and he was told in the draft, he's in the army now. Oh, and reveille. The boogie woogie be the horse of the day. They made a blow the boogie for his Uncle Sam. Really brought him down because he could not jam. The captain seemed to understand. The next day, the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumped when he plays reveille. The boogie woogie be the horse of the day. Root, tip, fruity, like tip, tip, go, go, go. He's blowing on his baby guitar, ain't with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. The boogie woogie bugle ball company be. Root, toot, fruity, like tip, tip, go. He's blowing on his baby guitar, ain't with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille.
Boogie woogie bugle bar company me. I'll return. Bring me all the love your heart can hold. Eyes will wait for me. Yeah.
Tequila.
I won't burden you with finishing this, but I wish you always the best. And it's not an impossible dream, because I'm sure you will make every day a pleasure. This was a wonderful wedding. Thanks for inviting us. We're going to stay all week. Hope the sisterhood doesn't mind.
Congratulations, Mark and Sharon. Mazel tov. And may you have many, many, many years of happiness.
Hey. Congratulations, Mark and Sharon.
Well, same for me, and have a happy life, the rest of your life. We love you.
Hi, Mark and Sharon. Congratulations. We're so happy for you. Hope you have a wonderful life.
Congratulations.
Hi, Mark and Sharon. Mark, at my wedding, it was your birthday. Now, 20 years later, it's your wedding and my birthday. Don't forget to send me a piece of cake. Thank you. Mazel tov.
Hey, Mark. Congratulations.
Hope you're enjoying this opportunity to see me in a tuxedo, one of the few chances you'll probably get in the near future. Congratulations once again, Mazel Tov. Wish you long and happy life. And here's Debbie.
Mark and Sharon, Mazel Tov. It was a pleasure to be here. Sharon, I'm so glad that we met. God knows, if I hadn't been so bored this summer, we probably would have never gotten to be such good friends. Hope your vacation was wonderful, your wedding was beautiful, and the rest of your life be just as beautiful.
I'd like to wish both of you the best of luck. It was a very long time waiting for this wedding, but as time grew closer, the time just passed so fast. And it was a beautiful day. Everybody had a wonderful time, and we just wish that you'll always be as happy as you are today.
Mark, I would like to welcome you to our family. Sharon could not have made a better choice, except if she chose her parents, of course. And we had a great time tonight. They even had me dancing more than I did my whole life combined. But all in all, we talked to many people. They had a ball, and they couldn't have been better. Anyway, we would like to, of course, wish you all the best. And we know everything's going to work out fine. And whatever we can do to help a little bit will give us as much joy as possible. Anyway, congratulations, as you know. We love you both.
Hello, Mark and Sharon. This is your Aunt Clara and cousin David. This has been a beautiful wedding. We're very happy to be here to share the simcha with you. We wish you a long, happy life together. Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov.
A one and a one and a one, two, three.
Love and marriage, love and marriage. It's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try, try, try to separate them. It's an illusion.
Yeah, now we start talking because we don't remember the words. Mark, Sharon, beautiful wedding. You did a great job. Sharon, you look beautiful. Mark, I'm just kidding. I'm sure you guys will lead a very happy life together, and I wish the best for you and many more years to come, and invite me over more often. No, I'm just kidding. Here's Alan.
Congratulations to the two of you. I think I pretty much said most of what I had to say earlier on tape, so you already have that. And congratulations and best of luck.
So you staring at the ocean, running fast along the sand, spirit born of earth and water, fire flying from your hands. In the instant that you love someone, in the second that the hammer hits, where wild horses run, where stars collide.
Hi, Sharon and Mark. Congratulations. It's a great party, and I'm really honored to be your bridesmaid.
Hi, Sharon and Mark. This is your Uncle Jerry from far away in Massachusetts with Grandma Molly from Florida. It's really, we're talking to you at the end of the wedding evening's celebration. We all had a wonderful time, and the whole weekend has been very special for me as well as for Grandma Molly. We just enjoyed seeing Sharon again, grown up, ready to take on the responsibilities and duties of a Jewish wife. And Mark, meeting you has been a great pleasure, and we think you're making a wonderful couple, a great start, and we wish you a long and healthy and happy life. And here's Grandma to say a few words.
To my darling Sherry and Mark, it was wonderful being here, and we enjoyed the wedding. It was great, and we wish you a long and happy, healthy married life.
We are the grandparents of Mark and Sharon. We wish them a lot of happiness. Mazel tov. They should be, as today, very, very happy. My name is Grandma Renee and Grandpa Enrique Benrey. Dile tu algo. Mazel tov.
Mazel tov, Mark and Sharon. I wish you a happy life together for many, many years.
Hi, Sharon. Hi, Mark. Best wishes. And it was a lovely wedding. I hope everything goes wonderful on your honeymoon. And I'll talk to you when you get back.
Okay. Hi, Mark, Sharon. May you both be blessed. You know we love you. And Mark, we are truly honored to have you as part of our family. And you know, we know you'll keep the Jewish tradition going. We're passing it on to you now. And you, in turn, will pass the Jewish tradition on to your family. God bless you and be well.
Have a long life and a happy one. And what can I tell you?
God,
we love you both very much.
Mark and Sharon, I am really happy to be here today and to be part of your lovely, lovely wedding. And I wish you the best. You know that I just can't express the happiness to be here and to have reached this moment. And I know that your father would have liked to have been here. And I really have no words to describe all my emotions right now. And I just hope that the two of you are very, very happy. And you have many children as you want, and that you raise them good as you want to see them. Give them everything that you can. And I know that you'll do a great job. Love you very much. Be seeing you soon, hopefully for many more Shabbat dinners tonight. And I love you.
First of all, I'd like to say Sharon and I are very happy to be married and to have gone through this wonderful ceremony and this wonderful reception. We'd like to thank my mother and Sharon's parents for putting on a wonderful party.
Everybody who could come. We had a wonderful time. And all our relatives.
All our relatives from
friends.
Out of town and friends.
Yeah.
And everyone who helped us enjoy this simcha.
Thank you for a wonderful party.
This party was excellent. Everyone seemed to be having a great time. And all the dancing that was going on. A lot of ruach out there. Anything else? We'd like to say hi to our kids and grandkids.
Yeah.
I hope you guys believe that this is actually
us.
This is actually us. Good night, everyone.
So you're dancing up the ocean, running fast along the sand. A spirit born of earth and water. Fire flying from your head. In the instant that you love someone, in the second that you
bye.